An easy way to customize your Blackboard Ultra course is to add a course image. If you haven't added an image yet, you'll need to go down to Details and Actions, and you'll see Course Image and the link to Edit Display Settings. Click on that, and a little slider will pop up on the right side. It'll show you that there's a default course image. That's what students would see if they are looking at their list of courses on the main menu. But here's where you can customize it. You click that picture icon next to course image, and you'll be able to upload a file or drag and drop there. I'm going to upload this template that we've created just to give you an idea of how the images will display in Ultra. So I upload this image, and you'll see that if it's full screen on my desktop, it takes up the whole screen. But if I make this window smaller, it's responsive. So you'll see that if it's half screen or lower, it reflects what's viewable on mobile, but those yellow parts on the side that are viewable on the desktop have disappeared. And then you see the same images used in the course card if students are using that view of their Blackboard courses. Really, what's important here is that you just want the main content of the image to be in that center safe zone. To upload your own image, click on the pencil icon in the top right corner or Edit Display Settings in the Details and Actions menu. Click the picture icon and upload your own image. No matter what size the image is, you should be able to move it around and resize it so that it is the right fit for the course image. You always want to add alternative text to this kind of image and click Save. So you'll see that course image pops up there, and as I adjust the size of the window down to a mobile size, it adjusts and is responsive to that change. And you can see the same thing on the course card image as well. If you want to be a little more intentional about what your course image is and how it displays, we've created that template that you can use. It's in Google Slides. The link is below in the video description. We've included steps for exporting this Google slide as a PNG, which would be what you would upload to Blackboard. And there's also the steps here for uploading your course image to Blackboard for your reference. The first thing you do to customize this image would be to go to File, Make a Copy, and go ahead and copy the entire presentation. It's just the one slide. You would navigate to where on your own drive you want it to copy, and that would make it so that you can edit it. Now from here, you can do as you please, but this is one easy method to make sure that your image is the right size. I'd upload an image from my computer, double-click on it to allow me to crop it, and then if I click and drag just out to the edges, that tells the image that this is as big as I want it to be. And so then I can resize the image, and it'll stay within that cropped window. I can click and drag it to find the part of the image that I want. And then if I go over here to Format Options and under Adjustments, I view the opacity. That's where I'd be able to easily take a look at whether what I want students to see at all times is in that middle area. If I drop the opacity down, I can see that template behind it and then raise it back up when I'm done. So let's say I'm happy with this image as my course image. I can go to File, Download, download it as a PNG, save it someplace that I know where it is, and title it. Now I'll go back to Blackboard and upload that image that I just saved. You'll see it doesn't let me crop it because it's exactly the right size. And I click Save, and I will see that in my course. And now you see when I resize the window, it's still keeping that main area that I was wanting students to focus on in the middle. Now, if I want to take this a step further and customize my images in a different way, I can go ahead and download this template just as a PNG itself by going to File, Download, PNG. And then I could bring that into whatever other image editing software I use, like Photoshop or Canva. I'll show you how to use Canva since it's a quick and easy way to do this. So I would go to Create a Design, and the custom size that you want to set is 1200 by 240. So that will be the size of the course banner. I would upload that template image and drag and drop that into my workspace here. Pull the corners out so that it's the right size and you see it fits right there in the workspace. Now you could do a similar workflow that I was doing in Google Slides by finding an image that you want to use, resizing that. In Canva, it does automatically just show you what your workspace is, so you don't have to deal with the cropping quite as much. So I'm gonna pull this up here so I have this nice space in the middle on that notebook. You see, if I drop the transparency down, that part is in my safe zone. So I'll add some text here. And I'd encourage you, if you are adding text to your image, keep it really simple. That's not where you want to contain a whole lot of detailed information, but some basics would be okay. I can always go up here to check my transparency by clicking the image and then the transparency icon, dragging it down just to make sure that what I want to stay in view of the students at all times is in that safe zone. So I pull that back up to 100%. I'm happy with how this image looks. So I'm going to click share in the top right corner, download, and then download it as a PNG. Click that download button, and it'll ask you for a name and where you want to save it. Now if I go back over into Blackboard, I can click that image icon and upload the image that I just made on Canva. Click next, you'll see it's the right size.
So we upload that image and we want to be sure to add alternative text, including the actual text that's in that image.
And click save. So you'll see it's nice right in the middle of my screen. It doesn't distort too much. If I pull it down to more of a mobile size, you see that the students would still be able to see it. I would want the text to be sufficiently large. You see this one gets pretty small. So just make sure that you're, if you are using text, you're using a big enough font size. So that's an easy way to add a course image to customize your course.
We hope this has been a helpful introduction to some of Blackboard Ultra's tools. If you're an instructor who needs support in Ultra, contact UAA's instructional design team at UAA_design@alaska.edu. If you're a student who needs support in Ultra, contact the UAA Technical Support Center by calling 907-786-4646 or emailing uaa.techsupport@alaska.edu.